You're now at the lab with Cold Spring Harbor Laboratory. My name is Nick Fiore, and this week at the lab, catch me if you can, sir. Early detection is crucial for successful cancer treatment. However, in many cases, cancer detection feels like a cruel game of catch me if you can. An extreme example is pancreatic cancer. According to the Lustgarten Foundation, the world's largest private funder of pancreatic cancer research, there are currently no early warning signs for this disease and no effective screening methods. That's the impetus for recent studies by Claudia Tonelli, a research investigator working with Professor David Tuveson in the Lustgarten Foundation Pancreatic Cancer Research Laboratory at Cold Spring Harbor.
We know that healthy adults have precancerous lesions in their pancreas. Of course, the chance of having them increases with age, but all of us at some point will have this precursor lesion in their pancreas. However, only very few of us will develop pancreatic cancer, so we were interested in understanding how these precancerous lesions evolve into cancer.
The idea is that if we understand the biology of this transformation, we may be able to intercept it. For pancreatic cancer, that'd be huge, because, as mentioned earlier, the disease is very hard to detect. The pancreas lies deep in the abdomen, behind the stomach, so during routine examinations, doctors don't see or feel tumors developing there. For now, known risk factors include chronic pancreatitis, diabetes, and a family history of pancreatic cancer.
These are some of the patient population we would be looking at, but hopefully in the future we will be able to further understand how these precursor lesions that most of us have will progress, and then this knowledge will become more useful.
Uses could include everything from treatments with fewer harmful side effects to better diagnostic tools, and even new prevention strategies. In other words, one day we could be looking at a situation where we're not just able to catch pancreatic cancer earlier. We'd be able to catch it before it becomes cancer in the first place. Once again, saving thousands of lives through the power of fundamental biology. Thank you once again for joining us at the lab. If you like what you heard, please subscribe wherever you get your podcasts and visit us online at cshl.edu. for more fundamental biology breakthroughs like this one. For Cold Spring Harbor Laboratory, I'm Nick Fiore, and I'll see you next time at the lab.